Alright, this is week 2, Highlander Platinum Season 14 match. Funk Blasters versus Wu-Tang Killer Bees. Also known as Bubble Bowl's team. My beginning loadout here is pretty silly. It's Soda Popper and Bonk. My thought is that I get infinite jumps and I can become invincible, so if there's an opportunity to go completely around their team with the Soda Popper jumps and the invincibility, then I'll do that. Maybe kill the teleporter or something stupid like that. Make every pick actually matter more. The thing is, if you kill the teleporter entrance, the engineer cannot go back to spawn to fix it. Like, he's needed at first, he's needed at second, there's no backing out. So that's one of those sort of permanent building picks that is very useful. So, I might touch the cart. I might just not. Depends on what I was thinking at this moment. Yeah, I'm not gonna touch the cart first. I'm just gonna go in. I'm calling sniper on the ground. Gun in that weird spot in the rocks. I don't like it there. I would not have done it. Yeah, I drank too fast, I think. Because I wasn't able to spot everything I needed to spot. Our demo's jumping in without a buff, and I don't know how I feel about that. Soldier's really in our spawn. I'm gonna try to waste his time by doing this right now. I just told our soldier, don't die to him. I'll come right back. Spy and scout fighting me over here. I'm currently Soda Popper jumping. There's nothing to do up here other than waste their demo's time. If I commit in the cart right now, I'm probably just gonna get spammed out and killed by snipers and stuff like that, so I'm not doing that until I know that we're pushing. I'm off the Soda Popper now because I'm not expecting anything to happen. This soldier, he bombs our sniper on defense, which you can't do. And then I don't know why the scout comes in, like, that just wasn't a good idea. We have Ubered, they're taking the guns, fire. I want to get in, like, make sure people don't get out here, like the sniper and such. I get the sniper. Should have been able to get medic, but... Wait, I think the medic does get killed by something here. Oh right, they're holding this corner now. Like, they don't back all the way out. Here's their scout. Like, they're basically giving it to us. Kills. That was a really, really bad call, whoever decided to stay in it and fight it first. So they have pretty much anything they need now. Maybe they were sacking so they had a sniper to defend in time. Alright, so even though my view models were off there, you can see my crosshair switching between blue for primary and purple for secondary, so just remember that if the view models ever turn themselves off again. Tech Dude has probably got better aim than me on scouts, so I'm not really gonna, like, kill myself trying to kill him. Here he comes again. He's really overextending, like, he knows he can kill me, and it's kind of unsettling. Like, the fact that no one else was main, it's kind of weird. I see the sniper dot, make sure everyone knows. Alright. 200 health, I'm not that afraid of him. I see reflecting rockets, so I'm gonna fight this guy. This is good terrain for me. That scout comes out of nowhere, I'm not happy about that. He ends up getting pyroclast, which is very nice for us. Our sniper just picked their medic, I have no idea how, but he does that. I want this NG pick. I really, really do. And we get it, alright. We should be able to take third without them ever being able to hold it now. But I'm going back to the cart and trusting my combo to do that. I want Yosh to get off this stupid cart. And Rhino goes too. The Soldier's so overcommitted. Like, it's absolutely stupid just how far in he is. Also, I don't know why I just get Ubered on the cart. That's a thing that happened, though. They have not managed to hold three at all, so this is really good for us. Pushing tires here. I see the soldier focusing him. I get killed, though. So, my damage didn't really matter because I get backstabbed, but it was really good damage. Tech Dude is the biggest threat, though. Tech Dude is their scout, to be absolutely clear. I'm returning to the fight already. I think our soldier's dead. He might not be. I'm backing up our sniper who's sniping from window right now. I peek this, not at all expecting to see anyone here, but there's a soldier and he does not put his rockets where they need to be put, so I get out of that. Yeah, if I was sniping on this map, I don't think I would peek from main very much, because that's where the sniper's going to be looking, whether or not he wants to kill you. Here the soldier's in. He jumps in, does not even see our soldier. Then I get out again by Tech Dude. However, I distract them and deal enough damage to both of them that our soldier's able to go, so it's not a huge loss. Yep, trying to push the cart, just get demo-manned right away. It'd be nice to avoid that, but it's not always possible. I thought he was gonna go into the shack for some health, but... yeah, right now I can't really fight him. I don't know why I keep trying. I guess it's because there's nothing else to do for Scout on Badwater other than just get killed by Splash. I'm trying the flank again. I know no one's in here because I've been like holding that area outside the flank. But I'm just gonna peek this lower area. Okay, I was thinking our spy had created enough of a distraction, but the spy was the sentry gun was looking at me. And then the pyro walks right into me when I'm trying to rush him. And it doesn't work out. It was called that the demo was really lit, so I went after him. Here, their medic drops to a body shot. It's amazing that they let us have map room like that. So when we get Uber, we push. Like, end of story. We got this. Here's their scout destroying me. But then I use the corner to my advantage. That sandwich was placed for someone other than me, but I took advantage of it. Another pyro's to the left of us still. Yeah, he's killing our gun. My gosh. Can't believe we let that happen. Sniper's up here. I decided that me shooting him is more important than actually getting the cart pushed. Because we have other people on it. Alright. Got all those cap points to top score. Let's see. I'm, as a scout on payload defense, I'm just gonna go suicide for the engineer's medal. But what weapon will I leave? The scattergun. Interesting choice. Yash is too busy looking at stats to suicide for medal. Great job, Yash. I believe I'm currently answering a Steam message.
Mission begins in 10 seconds. 5, 4, 3, 2,
Soldier's on the left with direct hit. He's a threat to our gun. He's shooting me for some reason. I want to remain a threat to him so he doesn't have space to shoot our gun. I don't care enough about the gun to walk into his rockets, though. That's not worth it. Our sniper's peeking here, so I'm thinking, try to get in the sniper. He is not shooting the mini. I don't know if he can or not, but that's a problem for me. And then he goes down. Losing sniper on Battle Order first is pretty bad, but yeah, we've lost a lot now. And we've just lost our medic too, so we gotta back out really, really right away here. I don't think we do it though. Yeah, I get the spy there based on luck because he runs back into me. I'm staying in just so I can get our engineer out. That's all I care about right now. Our sniper was so far forward there, it was crazy. There's a mini on that cliff, it's not gonna be doable to fight back. Our medic is back up, but I think we have a disadvantage. Could be wrong. Anyway, the hold was helped immensely by the fact that our medic manages to get back before they come in. Okay, so they've Ubered on us. They've killed our sentry now. We still don't have Uber. And they are just kind of rolling the fuck in right now. They've taken second before we can do anything about it, and our medic is stuck behind them. So we lose second, and we lose our medic. He takes forever to die, too. Yep, he just finally died. And then we managed to shoot their medic somehow. Here, I'm just annoying the fuck out of that heavy. Like, can't let him be alive and rush into us like this, so I'm just getting on him. And he gets the health kit, which is just so dumb. Because the Fist of Steel just pissed me off so much. Here, I know their Pyro doesn't have very good DM, so I just go after it. That would be really stupid against a good Pyro. I'm expecting Sniper to be in here one of these times that I peek, but he has not yet done so. Now I'm just watching it, because their soldier's in. I'm telling them to spam it out. Demo and soldier both rotate over there. I'm just peeking in there. I'm not gonna push it. Now I'm gonna check boiler again. After this mini goes down, I think. I want to actually go into boiler, but I'm not getting buffed. I'm hesitating a lot. I'm calling now that they're moving into the house. I believe they're gonna Uber now. They got our heavy. I get their sniper, which is good. Now I'm kind of behind them. I don't know where their mini is, and their scout engages. Took too much damage to get out of that. Okay, they're pushing up a lot. That demo pick is gonna help a ton. Okay, they have 3 minutes and 20 seconds left to push both of these points. Oh, the spy is very unlucky. I think he does get away. I'm just trying to take all this ammo so he doesn't get out. Found him. I have absolutely no idea what to do about this. Like, you can see me visibly having major problems with this guy. I do forget to, like, spy check him Well, I mean, I drop the issue and then go after actual picks again. Here, their heavy's like really far forward. If he didn't turn and face me right away, I would have chased the pick, but. Here, I have no idea why I don't kill that spy, and I realized later that he died to the heavy, and I didn't get an assist. So I was like really confused about where he went. Now that we're on the last hold, my job is probably going to watch either tires or map room, depending on the situation. I do a lot of sniper babysitting, where I either protect our sniper, or I will like keep him, or I'll like annoy their sniper. Here I go in to pick up the sandwich, and Rhino has already done that, so I die. I give him lots of shit about that, don't worry. Here are spies on them, but this doesn't work out. Our gun's dead. This is looking bad for our hold. Soldier dead. Very nice. Well, that heavy wasn't looking at me, so I got an easy kill on him. Then the medic, too. That wasn't an easy kill, that was just a, right time, sort of thing. I want to make sure we don't lose our medic or our demo, so I go back to there instead of going after more picks. I just got body shot, and I know he's going to be watching that health kit, so I hesitated there. I don't know why there are stickies there, like, that makes no sense to me. I'm just kind of looking around right now, analyzing where to go. I've decided to go tires. And their scout is destroying me in 1v1s right now. I want to get a buff so I can fight him. Oh my god, where the fuck did he go? Like, I have absolutely no idea where he came from, but that was an awareness issue. That was a really great kill for our spy right there. I remember being really proud of him. Ooh. I have 10 seconds to push the cart that far and it's not gonna happen. Basically just boosting stats right now. I have a week 2 lakeside demo? That's not accurate. I'm gonna speed through this setup time because you've already seen it. Alright, right at the start I get hit really hard, so I'm backing up a little for health. Here I walk into that rocket because I didn't think yet he had another one loaded. It was really stupid of me. Thinking if I can kill this scout, that'll make it easier for us, but no, he backs out. Soldier's so far in, I'm just like, you're my kill. They're pushing in on the fact that they had a Bonk Scout run in. Not really enough of an advantage to use an Uber. So yeah, our gun's still up and our medic's still up. The combo's walking up this side now. I'm harassing but not committing. Okay, our combo's walking out here. I'm staying in just enough to keep fighting things, but then I realized, like, oh crap, this is probably too much. Yeah, I wanted to be the last one out so that they would slow down, not pressure our team, but the thing is, like, our sniper there, he didn't back out as fast as I wanted him to. My idea was to save his life. by making it look like too dangerous to rush after him, but I guess they took my staying in as it's safe to stay in, so that's just miscommunication. Here, I'm making sure the sniper and the flank don't get too far in, but they kind of get too far in before I can do anything about it. This heavy, he gets so far in, and I hit him with the four shots, but he manages to kill me. Because he had 450. I don't know what to say about that death other than just don't fight heavies with 40 health. There's heavy here. I don't know why I have an Uber. I really wanted to kill him. We're giving up second just so we can get a third hold going. Calling that there's a lot in there, including Pyro, and our soldier's just like, fuck it, I don't want any of this. And yet our sniper's holding right there. Like, that's just suicide. Oh, and I was standing still and I didn't notice that he'd rotated already. Very bad luck for me. Our spy is trying to be a distraction right now, and I'm just saying, like, cloak, run away, and go for backstabs, buddy. Can't contest third if that mini stays up, so I don't really know what to do here. Their scout goes down, their mini goes down. NG's a pick here that we can get. This demo... Yeah, I pressure him, but it's not gonna happen. Here the Wrangler is like, he's doing so much knockback that I miss all of my shots because my position is not what I think it is. And it just kills me so fast. It was really ridiculous. Wrangled minis are pretty broke. Alright, what am I doing here? Okay. Probably telling someone about how much I hate wrangled minis. I do that a lot. I want a buff so I can peek, but it doesn't happen for way too long. Here their Uber has popped on a heavy, and I'm just like, okay. Engineer pick! Pyro pick! I don't get out though. Should not have done that. See, I thought they would be like going in and the sniper would be there and I could kill things and then get behind them and grab some health, come back. But what ends up happening is that we just kind of leap people through our flank and the scout's way behind us. We finally give up third at 5:10, which is a little early, honestly. I'm not happy. I have to get lower resup because I'm not useful right now. Remember that lower resup is pretty much just as close as that big health kit is. And that heavy keeps trying to make heavy class like interesting and like impressive by like going in for plays and stuff, but it's not. You play passive or you suck. Here they've Ubered in without a heavy. I'm just thinking, hey, everyone behind their combo is just gonna be an easy kill. So that's what I'm doing, I'm fighting behind the combo. The combo's backed up. We stopped the cart, so their push is pretty much wasted, and now we have Uber advantage. I'm just picking for spy and stuff. And sniper's right there, the tubes. I want to get spam on him really badly so I can kill him, but it's not gonna happen. Now I decided to just watch map room. Our soldier's in here. So I decided not to. I did not know he was in there when I went in. Here's their scout. I don't want to fight him. I know he's really good, so I'm just like, fuck it. Just spamming them. They've both taken like 60 or 100, so... I've done something. Now I'm gonna go back in with full health because I know neither of them have it. Here's the scout. Ah, this is really messy. I already did 100 to the scout, I should have shot him first. Like, there was no reason to shoot the medic yet. He wasn't getting out, I had him pinned. Alright, what now? Back into the tires. I don't actually hold tires because they're all main. Just killing the NG was really good there, like, helpful. I don't even know where the mini is that it did that much damage to me. I don't really know what I should have done there. Sentries, eh? I say. I crack me up. I'm enjoying watching this hold here because it looks like we're really doing a good job. I'm back on the soda popper now. For whatever reason. Soldier with it. I see that guy's in map room. It's a pyro. He's not really a threat, so I don't really put too much mind to it. The scout's suiciding for a pick on me, and it's just like, come on. I can't hit him because I'm sucking at the moment. Here are pyros going after the spy pick when he doesn't need to. He should be trying to save our heavy, but then he gets stuck in the corner where there's nothing he can do. Here I'm on the force of nature because I know that literally nothing I do matters. Then I miss two shots and die. I do this faster. The gun's in a normal spot, and then I back up. I'm gonna hold cliff, check for stickies in the lamp and on this rock. I don't mind getting killed by the stickies. Like, if I bait him into dead any sticks, I don't really care. My spawns are fast, and I can't do anything on offense anyway. Here I'm wasting sniper and soldier ammo. I hear this spy shooting behind me, and I really should be fighting him. I drank the bonk to run out there, and also I'm gonna take it off in favor of my pocket pistol. I think their gun... yeah, the gun gets moved up here. And the demo's like fighting me. Sniper gets our sniper like really easy. And then he gets me too. I was about to get the engineer too. It really sucks trying to pressure a sniper on this map, because you can't cover any ground with all the spam and the sentries and stuff. Their medic runs into a pill there and does not get out first. So we're thinking, okay, we're going to take up as much ground as we can. Our pyro should not be here. I know our soldier wants to get on roof, but the pyro had no reason to. I don't know where we're holding right now as a team. I think we might be on the roof, or we might be, like, just spawn camping. Yeah, we're spawn camping, which is the right thing to do. Here's their soldier just coming out of nowhere and getting nothing done. That was sort of his thing, is where he would just sort of disappear for, like, 2 minutes and then just come in for a bomb and then die. Because his bomb was so remote that no one could help him, and there was no damage to clean up on. No one could clean up on his damage either, because, like, they're on the cart, there's a medic by him. Here's the thing. I was riding the cart that whole time, and I get off to shoot that spy, because he was on our medic and our demo, and I immediately hear someone say, "Can we get times 3 on a cart?" And I'm just like, what the hell? So I'm not allowed to, like, save our medic or anything? Like, come on. Here we go, I'm pushing in. I kind of get behind them here, which isn't the smartest thing, but I get the soldier before I go down. That dude is playing really passive when he knows he's getting outnumbered, which is the right thing to do. So it did not go very well to shoot against him. Because, like, if I'm aggressive at all, I don't think the rest of my team can keep up with it because the scout's movement is too fast. And it doesn't cost them ammo or health. So I know the scout's hurt and above. I'm kind of waiting for him to come down, but it's just... their demo's pressuring this area too hard. Now that it's open, I'm trying to go in and clean up on the flank. But there's nothing to clean up. I'm just not going to risk it. Here I go in, and our soldier is convinced that I'm a spy, and he spends this entire fight shooting me while I'm trying to 1v1 tech dude, and then he gets killed. And then if you watch this, I kill Wilson after he turns the corner. Like, the last shot doesn't even show a damage number. It's amazing. I don't know where any of them are right now. I'm just kind of holding this area for a sniper. See, when you're up here, pretty much the only one you're gonna kill is the other sniper, so that's kind of what we're banking on. I'm trying to capitalize on the fact that he's wasting his time shooting a gun, and that lets me get the pick on that scout. That was one of the few times when, like, I can just rush tech dude and get away with it, because he's really good. And we get their soldier too, which makes the flank open. And I want to return to our engineer and, like, help him out with whatever he's doing with his sentry. But, like, the spy gets to him before I can do anything. I'm thinking maybe sniper's up here and I can kill him, but he's not. That's an Uber on the cart. I should not be here. The spy's a big threat. If he hits me once, I'm dead. He does not, luckily. Wrapping around looking for, like, small health kits, pressuring their sniper out of here. I hear I drop down, and the medic is just... he falls back into the secluded area where his team can't help him, and then I get an easy kill. The demo's too focused on everything else to be able to shoot me, so is engineer. Like, that just wins us the round. Or does it? Ha ha ha. We still have a lot of time to push this last, though. This last hold from them, it was categorized by... I guess, like, how I would explain it is that... we pushed off of real advantages, but we executed them so badly that we didn't do very well. Because their medic died in really stupid ways 3 times in one last hold, I believe. Or maybe it was 2. But, like, it's kind of inexcusable that we took this long to push last. At the very least, we got cart time every single time we went in. The thing is, we don't get in very often. Okay, we have a gun here again, so I'm just like, okay. I know it did damage, I don't know how much, so I'm not gonna pressure. If that demo had walked all the way in, I would have gone after the pick, but then if you look at the kill feed right now, our spy just killed demo, heavy, and medic. So right now any pick you get is, like, super duper valuable. Because it's, like, the only one that can do any damage. So I'm thinking I don't need to be on the cart that bad, but then other people don't move up. At this point, they have pretty much nobody that can fight, and then it's just round over. Okay, so that game was, like, really messy. The other team made a lot of mistakes, which was what made us actually get the win. Without them making those stupid mistakes, we probably would have lost. But at the same time, when we made a stupid mistake, they didn't capitalize on it at all. So I have kind of mixed feelings about like how we actually played in that match. All right, thank you for watching.